So we often, when learning a skill, on when we're training, when we're on trying to make progress of some kind, we always we often put ourselves actually outside of our thrive zone. We put ourselves into situations in which something is so challenging for us that it is outside of our success area. In that, outside of our control a little bit, and that we believe that that is where change really happens. That if I manage to stay more on zones in which I am not very proficient, that's what I learn. And that's quite wrong. In my experience, what you want to do is you want to spend most of the time in your thrive zone. So you want to put yourself in situations in which your training, or like the skill that you're trying to learn, you want to put yourself, expose yourself to experiences in which you know you're gonna be successful, in which you are gonna have some kind of external aid that is gonna create the context in which you are successful. For example, think about a 5K in which everything goes well. A 5K in which the first mile is a slow, like a fast pace but an easy pace. The second mile is a pace in which you start just to like keep up with your planned pace. You have to accelerate a little bit and you're pushing really hard, but you can't stay with that pace. And in the last mile, you're pushing really hard and it's still increasing the speed, and you finish with giving everything you got. And when you finish, you have zero doubts that that was an amazing performance for you. If you look at that, that is a thrive, that is the definition of the thrive zone. It's not a performance that is outside of your capacity. It's exactly within your capacity. You actually were right in the thrive zone. The external aid there was the race strategy that yourself or your coach gave you. That was your aid. The watch, all the guidance that you needed to perform that race, but you were never away from your thrive zone. What happens, for example, is, and when, like, let's keep the example of the running. What happens is that most of the time we don't train in that thrive zone. We want to be away, like we want to be over that thrive zone. We want to be better, and so we think that we have to be outside of our thrive zone. And so, for example, the most common case is you're gonna start that race way above the pace that you're gonna be able to sustain. You're outside your thrive zone. You cannot do that. And so then in the second and third mile you crash, and your performance is definitely not as good or successful. Good. So in training, or we're learning a skill, you wanna be in that thrive zone. You want to be and put yourself in context in which you're going to be successful. And that is one big misunderstanding, I think, that people has, especially in the fitness world. Good. So this finding this thrive zone is not as easy as it sounds, and it's not as evident, and it requires several things. It requires like mainly three things, but yeah, it requires several things. First, it requires a lot of acceptance. You have to accept where you are. You have to differentiate where you want to be from where you are right now. That's hard. That requires a lot of self-knowledge, which is the second thing that the thrive zone requires, that you know yourself very well. And if you cannot know yourself very well, then you need somebody else that does that for you. For example, a coach. Good. And the third thing that the thrive zone requires is that you really pay attention to how when to move that thrive zone, right? Like, we want to always stay in the successful zone, but also on that edge when like it's challenging, when I need that external guidance to make it challenging, right? In the example of my 5K, I needed all the practice before to design a very well-crafted race plan that was just right for me. All that guidance, I couldn't have done it just by running. I needed all that to be successful. And so we need to like adjust the thrive zone as we get better. Good, let me, in order to make this concept a little bit easier to understand, let me give you something. And is where this concept comes from, which is important. This concept comes from the concept of zone of proximal development by Vygotsky, which is an educational concept used by teachers all over the world. That is awesome because it states that learners, children especially, but learners should spend most of their time in their zone of proximal development, which is the thrive zone for us. And that zone is the zone in which they are exposed to skills or tasks that they can perform aid, but that they couldn't perform on aid, right? And the model states that if you keep children in that area for the longer, is when they learn the most. My experience with my clients and with myself tells me that that concept does apply to adults, and it applies in a nice, nice way. That's exactly where we learn. Your task, if you're watching this video, is after you finish here, you're gonna find yourself for tomorrow, maybe a task in your training or your nutrition or whatever skill is that you're learning, your German learning, if you're learning a new language, you're gonna put yourself in a context in which you're successful, but it's challenging. For example, I can run a 6-minute mile. That is a fast mile for me. Like, I could do it once, but I couldn't do it twice. And so I am gonna do tomorrow a workout in which I am gonna run 7-minute miles bouts, and I'm gonna give myself a little bit of rest, suboptimal rest, like think about 2 to 3 minutes of rest. And I'm gonna keep that pace, and I know I can do that for 3 to 4 rounds, and so I'm gonna set up myself to be successful, but I also know it's gonna be very, very challenging, but there's no doubt that I can do it for me, just because based on the aid of my previous results and so on. So my ego, I know that's my thrive zone. If I were to do the same workout and I wasn't checking for my thrive zone, probably I will try to go to 6:30 because that's where my ego will want to be, or even 6, and see if I could hold on to that 6, because I know deep inside that if I could hold to that 6, then I would be faster, and what I really want is to be faster. But that wouldn't be my thrive zone. That would be just my wishing. That would be me wishing that were my thrive zone. So I'm going to put myself in the thrive zone because I know that that's where the results come from. I know where that's where the learning happens. I know that that third round I'm going to have to push really hard to keep that pace, which is the skill that I actually need to be faster. And I also know deep inside that I'm going to be able. So both things are going to happen. And that is where the magic is going to happen. So that would be my example. Another example, if you want a nutritional, just before I leave, is to find a skill nutritionally in which, whoa, look at this cat, in which I am gonna be successful but challenge. For example, for me, that is going to be track how do I feel after lunch. And I'll tell you why. I have a very, very structured eating, and so I now want to know if what I'm doing, how is affecting my energy levels. But I do know that it's challenging for me to remind myself, even if I put reminders on the phone or whatever, to remind myself and do that. But I know I can. So I could go all out and be like, I'm gonna track how I feel all through the day and like write notes for the morning and the afternoon. And I know that that is outside my control. I know because I have tried. So that's outside my thrive zone. So I'm just gonna do it after lunch because I know I can do that. And then from then on, I'll change. And I'm gonna start tracking how my energy levels are to see if I need to do any nutritional changes to my diet right now, which is very stable, and I can do that. So anyhow, those are my two examples. Find your thrive zone, stay within it, and thrive.